What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. My name's Leon, and I'm under the president's orders to rescue you! Ashley! I hate that bitch. I love Resident Evil 4, don't get me wrong, but thank you for the suggestion, Hens Plays. Guys, today we got the official Season 2 trailer showing off a couple of new weapons, possibly a first glimpse at a new streak, and of course, we got some new operators to talk about this time around. Really hope you guys enjoy the video. Let's go ahead and kick things off by talking about what's going on in the trailer. Before the events of the Season 2 trailer, Adler was captured by Stitch in the mall. Since that happened, Frank Woods has regrouped and got another team. They're going into Laos to try and rescue Adler. I thought for sure that they would be going back to Rebirth Island. I thought that Adler would be taken to Verdansk somewhere, but this is completely separate from both of those two areas. So I don't know how Laos is going to play into it. Perhaps we'll see a new map that takes place here. Maybe we'll see an extension to the Warzone experience because this has got to tie into Warzone as well. So I'm a little confused on how that's going to work. We'll talk more about that towards the end. So this trailer kicks off with an unnamed soldier running through the woods, being completely scared by spooky, scary skeletons all around, bumping into this masked man right here. And we know now that his name is Naga, and he will be the new bad boy of Season 2, the face of Season 2, if you will. He's going to be working alongside Stitch, and he's going to be in charge of those big boy, bad boy operations over in Laos. At least that's the vibe that I get. After the helicopter flies overhead, he pops on the radio and lets Stitch know that Adler is completely secure and headed to Stitch, which just so happens to be situated in Verdansk. So that's how they're tying the story together there. And yes, I did just accidentally say situated, but I'm gonna keep it there. It's canon now. So while Adler has found himself in a sticky situation, we also have Frank Woods and team also finding themselves in a similar situation with Naga and the enemy fiends on the ground. They're going right into a trap. They have no idea that Adler's been moved, and they're just going based off of past intel. With the story set aside, let's talk about the content that we're actually able to see throughout this particular trailer. Let's talk about the three new operators that are going to be coming as part of Season 2. The first one we've already been discussing, and that is the bad boy in Laos, Naga. He is going to be our bad boy character, and I would assume that he's going to be Stitch's right-hand man in some way, shape, or form when it comes to the operations taking place in Laos. The second character, we don't have an official name for just yet, but it has been leaked. The name is Wolf, and he's a hulking man. He looks awesome. I think that his specific character design is great with the ghillie suit hanging off his back. He's got a pair of night vision goggles on his chest. I wonder how that's going to come into play moving forward. I have no clue. And finally, we have Rivas. Rivas is referred to by name by Wolf, and she is the badass with the crossbow. I think my wife is going to be very, very excited to play as this character. And it's awesome to have another waifu in Cold War. I don't think anyone will disagree with that. I'm still simping for Park though, just saying. Throughout this trailer, there are also three brand new weapons spotted, the first one being this submachine gun. Now, we all are thinking that this is going to be the LC-10 SMG that was leaked a while ago. There was no models for it shown in game, so it's very well possible that this is exactly that. It kind of looks like the Kaparis to me, but you guys be the judge. Let me know in the comment section below. The second weapon that was shown is the crossbow. We've spoke about this before. I'm very happy that we're finally being able to see it. I love weapons like this. We need another special category weapon. The crossbow fits that perfectly. Hopefully this time around we get the sniper scope for the crossbow like we should have had it back in the original Black Ops game. Give us multiple different tips like we had back in Modern Warfare as well. That'd be pretty cool. Last but most certainly not least, we have the Galil, which is shown very, very quickly, but I would imagine that maybe this is going to be part of the battle pass. So I think the SMG and the Galil will be part of the battle pass, and then the crossbow, since it's a special weapon, you'll most likely have to use the thumper or something in order to unlock it. But I guess we'll have to wait and see just exactly what happens. There's always an opportunity that all three weapons show up in the battle pass. Who knows? So of course we cannot ignore the elephant in the room, or should I say the minigun in the room. This thing is massive, it's loud. This is most likely going to be the death machine, and it's probably going to make a return in the form of a Scorestreak. It's kind of crazy to see it, and I would imagine Wolf is just strong enough to pull the minigun turret off of the helicopter and do this, but I definitely think it makes more sense to see a minigun or a death machine make an appearance. Also, this means a whole lot for the zombies community as well. Imagine being able to buy the minigun. You're going to be able to take out enemies super quick and have a lot of ammo to do so. I'm excited for that, and I hope you guys are too. I had some people sending me this image over on Twitter saying, didn't you see the Annihilator? And I hate to burst your bubble, but this is not what the Annihilator looks like in Black Ops Cold War. We know what it looks like because you can actually pick it up in the campaign. What we are seeing here in this image is the Magnum that has the Task Force barrel and the 12-round speed loader. Unfortunately, it's not the Annihilator, but there's still hope that that will make its way into the multiplayer in the form of a streak as well, and I would imagine that's going to happen sooner than later. Throughout this trailer, you'll also see really unique outfits on our operators. Now, I don't know who these operators are because I thought this dude over here in the far back, I thought this guy was a brand new guy. But maybe this is Baker in a specific outfit. I don't know. The face doesn't really match up, though. It's possible that maybe they changed the way that this character looks in order to make the outfit look a little bit better. Don't know. Not entirely sure on that. You'll also notice that these characters are using specific blueprints that don't exist in the game yet. The character here on the left, this female character, is using a MAC-10 blueprint that we don't have in the game. And then this character right here is using a Bison blueprint, which is very, very difficult to see. It's there for like a split second, but we don't have those in the game yet. It's just a matter of time before they're added in. Now, the final thing that was shown today was actually not in the trailer. It was tweeted alongside the trailer by Treyarch, and this is what they said. Breach scale large, status 0% contained. And then we get this gif of, well, a chandelier inside of a building that kind of looks like a church. You can see that there's a stained glass window in the back. It looks like a peace sign or something up there. So really, the entire thing is confusing. Many people are saying, oh my gosh, Kino Der Toten's coming back. I don't feel that. I think that this is our very first teaser towards the Outbreak mode, which we've been talking a lot about over the past couple of weeks. Outbreak is a large-scale zombies experience that takes place on Fireteam maps. So if anything, this could be a new Fireteam map that we're seeing for the first time, shown through the eyes of the Outbreak mode. Outbreak, though, is going to be amazing. It's going to be fantastic. I'm excited to see what that does for the story. And not to mention, I'm excited to see another Fireteam experience. So, with that said, that is pretty much it for everything that came out today. If there's more stuff that releases over the next 24 hours, I will make sure to keep you all updated. It might come in the form of a late night upload tonight. I don't know yet. Stay tuned. But if you all enjoyed this video here, please, please, please do me a favor and ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. Join the notification squad. I know that a lot of you are subscribed to the channel already, but ringing that bell really does help. And I noticed that many more of you have been doing it recently. So thank you so much. I truly appreciate it. The other thing that you do is leave a like, leave a comment. Of course, that helps with interactions. And of course, I'll be down there commenting with you. Thank you all so much for joining me on this video here today. I hope you're excited for season 2 like I am. And I'll catch you all on the next video. Peace.